everybody. Back on again and decided to go ahead and do this game again. I think yesterday I said what game I was going to stream next is going to be up in the air. I just had a bunch of other games that I was wanting to play as well. But I just went ahead and decided to go ahead and play this one instead. So, but also, like usual, I'm in the process of setting up here. So, kind of bear with me on that. Simulator. Hey, I got almost 300 people in there. That's pretty rare. I guess they must have both streamers driving trucks in there or something. Okay, so not a whole lot else going on, it seems. So let's get that up. Chat box going. So that and that. I want to play with the controller, so. So let me check my Twitch app, make sure it's actually working, because it has a habit of malfunctioning. I've had people try chatting with me, but it doesn't show up in my tab at all because my app decided to just start fucking up on me. So. Okay, app works. And also, like usual, gonna have me a protein shake. Since I've been working out recently. And gonna have some grapes. And last we left off on Fort Joy. And as far as the session goes, probably gonna just do my usual. Just, doing some pickpocketing, doing some stealing. Trying to make some money. Trying to get some good gear. disease check. Waypoint.
Arr. Yo ho ho and a bottle of rum.
Hey, how's it going? Just doing my usual. Just stealing stuff. Yeah. Almost the same thing as in Baldur's Gate. Same thing I used to do in Baldur's Gate. Like steal from shops and stuff. But here, it's like a more elaborate process. Like, unlike Baldur's Gate, once you stole an item, nobody ever came after you. Especially in Baldur's Gate 2. Like, they never sent guards after you or anything. Whereas in here, Once I grab an item, I have to teleport out and head over to here. I gotta dump it off because, people have a habit of searching me. Oh, excuse me. And not really sure what to do about stealing equipment. They're probably gear upgrades, but I'm guessing they can still find it on you. So, drop it. There ain't nothing in it. And this is what I gotta do. and kind of embarrassing. I have the same kind of tags that this guy does. On my last game, I think it was a scholar and noble.
You leave me be. Just leave.
Oh, let me run out of here real quick before I'm caught. Yeah, she just went robbed. So gotta bail. Let me head over here. Oh, that's right. I went with Jester instead. Sometimes when you're in conversation with somebody, you have one or both of these tags here will come up. Or I should say, human will come up too. I think it's random. But, it's just another, conversation option.
Amidst a crowd of screws, bolts, and scraps of metal, the woman is manipulating a glove-like contraption fitted with five long metal skewers. She doesn't...
I'll put these on.
And what you after? I ain't. Just seeing how it's made. She's clever, Dallas. Made these herself for those bodyguards of hers. Boy, they're sharp.
She looks up.
You looking to buy something?
So, get on him. The trick is, gonna try to get her over here, somewhere around this area.
Who in their right mind would think of a thing like this?
Yeah, I don't want her over there. I'm gonna try to initiate conversation with her, but I gotta get her facing away from her area. Not like that.
Amidst a crowd of screws, bolts, and scraps of metal, the woman is moving.
Die. Got her facing the wrong way.
And what you after?
Got her facing the wrong way.
Amidst a crowd of screws, bolts, and scraps of metal,
manipulating
a glove-like contraption.
Okay, now we got it. How?
looks up as you approach, wiping her brow with a grease-blackened hand.
How? She's facing the other way. Oh.
Die.
I gotta sneak first. Here, let me try this.
The woman looks up as you.
What do you need? By all means, get an eyeful.
I picked some flowers for you.
Yeah, there you go. I don't use those because, unlike a lot of other RPGs, area effect attacks will damage your own guys as well as theirs. Try it again, shall we? This time, be sure to sneak, Joe. Wait till she comes out here.
Who in their right mind would think of a thing like this?
Again, wait until she comes out here, and I have to make sure she's facing southeast.
Up as you approach, wiping her brow.
That's how it's done. Actually, let me up. Oh shoot, no. Okay, good. The stolen tag didn't come up. that's actually the one I'm looking for. Yeah. Yeah, White, that battle went a lot quicker than anticipated. All the guys I was supposed to be rescuing, they're all pretty good at, fighting themselves. I was expecting to be, expecting a lot of knockdown, drag-out battles in that boat. Oh, duelist.
Spin to win, baby.
Uh-oh. Game crash. Okay, there we go. I forgot all about that. When's it coming out? Well, if it's anything like WoW Classic, it'll be on my plate. I'll probably play it eventually. I probably won't play it the very moment it comes out, though. You're probably gonna have, like, server issues. It's gonna get all crowded and whatnot. Probably the same thing that happened in WoW Classic. Nobody will be able to get on because, servers are all clogged up. It's log, it's big and heavy, it's what? Oh, excuse me. I want to grab those nails, but they got a guy over west keeping an eye on them. I think there's something else I was wanting to grab over here too. But for those that don't, for those that haven't noticed, one theft tactic involves having your other party member go up and actually initiate a conversation with her, like they're doing here. The whole point being keeping her distracted and facing away from where you wanna steal stuff. So I pretty much have free rein on everything over here, but I want to steal equipment, especially if they're upgrades. But think of it is I don't want to be caught with them on me. Otherwise, I'll probably end up I'll have to give them up, or I'll have the whole town after me, that kind of thing. It's considered stolen, so back to the beach. Inventory. Hold in hand. Pause. Pause. I'm trying to get the game paused so I can use a waypoint before somebody discovers me with all them stolen items on me. What I'll go ahead and do. Okay, there, back to the square.
Ifan rolls his sleeves back down and casually wipes some blood from his cheek. He nods at
good work there. Good work. I can tell you've got chops. Say, you were on the ship here with me, weren't you?
He stretches out one rough hand to shake yours. He grips your hand tight as a vice and shakes it hard.
Say, you don't look all that busy now that we're safely on dry land. I could use someone to watch my back, and it looks like you could. I've just got a small errand to run, and then I'll be looking to get the hell out of here while I've still got a neck to collar. How about we stick together until we get out of this place?
Okay, I don't want a third person in my party. Probably the biggest reason is I have the lone wolf trait. I can have no more than one other person in my group. Any more than that, and I lose all my buffs.
He shrugs, looking off to the south.
Mercenaries. It's a job. My job. Everyone needs to make a living. I make mine running errands.
The little black cat trailing you hisses at him, hair raising a ridge along its back. Without batting an eyelid, the man rumbles a lupine growl. Hides behind your leg, mewling.
That's the truth. For me, for you, for everyone in this place. Why not help each other get out of here?
He gazes around admiringly at the decrepit surroundings in which you find yourself.
Funny boy. Stick around a while. That'll change. Two heads are better than one. And when push comes to shove, four fists are better than two, right? No harm having a friend in this place. One hand washes the other and all that. Trust me, like I said, suit you.
Can't run with him, and to say nothing of the fact that I have just robbed him blind. I mean, I don't think you'd want him in my group. Okay, so I'm thinking I'm good to go with her.
What do you need? By all means, get an eye for it.
So she's a summoner. Yeah, I need one of those too.
I got you curious. Yeah, funny name for a gal like that. When I knew her, the Feather would have been a likelier name. Oh, I don't know. She was a sweet soul, quiet, loved her family. Always seemed strong, as I recall, but she didn't come across as no fearless military leader back then. She was just a girl. People do change, don't they?
She nods once.
Clever lass, her. No wonder what Alexander sees in her. Question is, what she sees in him.
Yeah, so far, apparently she hasn't noticed anything. Okay. She is good to go on that. Alright. I'm all done with her. Okay, the disease girl is in there. I think I've talked to her already. I think one thing I am gonna do is I'm probably gonna go on the wiki.
You forget my name, yeah?
Let me go over here. Oh. Actually, there are. I'll be there in a second. I just want to get this. There it is. I'm trying to find the quest. Come on, back up. Okay, I'm looking for somebody named Stingtail. Not him. I don't think she's in here. Oh, but yeah. In fact, they're pretty open and transparent about it. It's right here in the cheat menu. But, I guess one drawback, if you want to call it that, a lot of these are permanent. The moment you choose them, you can't go back on them. And, if you have any unlocked, or if you're using any of them, you won't be able to gain achievements. Well, there's a gate reference right here. Because a lot of these, I don't want on all the time. I mean, you know, I'd only want on, you know, just enough to get me over a sticking point in the quest or something like that, but not permanent. There's also a bunch of game mods you can use on here too, but same thing there. The moment you use them, achievements are turned off.
Frightfully busy at the moment, love. Haven't got any liquor on hand, have you? This fella could use a little comfort. Why, look at that. Just what I ordered. Ain't you a peach, love? An old deal here. Thank you too, if you could. Poor fella over there crossed one of Griff's card sharks and got a club to the skull. Don't want to be sure, but I'd like to ease his way out.
Huh? Drunk.
The man sleeps so deeply, he might as well be dead to the world.
Huh.
Hey, buddy, wait.
Focuses at the cat at your feet, barely.
Actually, yeah, a bit on the heavy side.
What's this? I found something.
I need to buy a shovel.
I don't have the right tool for digging.
Okay, one moment. I'm gonna look up shovel on the browser. See where I can get one. Okay, never mind.
One must put in due effort if one is to reap the proper reward.
The dog focuses at the cat.
Look what I got, buddy. I got your key.
The dog focuses at the cat.
Okay, I guess you couldn't care less. And again, I'm looking for a guy named Stingtail. Happy him.
This looks like the crates I'm after. But where are the contents?
Yeah. It's like sniffing the chocobo. On one moment, you're saving the entire universe from complete destruction, and it's another moment later, you're smelling a chocobo's ass.
Just as you're about to address the lizard, the Red Prince bars you with an outstretched arm.
This man is a dreamer. As you know, I need a word with him. You may wait here while I... Permission, indeed.
He bids the dreamer stand up and pay attention, which he does in a groveling and awkward manner. The dreamer then chews and swallows a handful of Trudenay leaves before slipping into a trance-like state. He falls asleep. To your surprise, the Red Prince lies down and follows suit. After about half an hour, they wake up and begin to discuss what they saw in their dream.
Huh?
The Red Prince pinches the bridge of his nose in apparent irritation before turning his back on the jabbering dreamer. You receive a withering glance in response.
A deserved bit of sarcasm, I suppose. But though this stingtail fellow may be a less than stellar specimen in the firmament of dreams, the dreams themselves prove to be quite elucidating. Turns out I'm being hunted by an enemy I didn't know actually existed. The myth-shrouded House of Shadows. The dreamers, though, they're on my side. And they visions of me on the throne. Of course it is. I was born with the promise of an empire, and that promise will be kept. But to keep it, I must find a second dreamer. A greater one. A more experienced traveler of the dream world. Bahara is her name, and she resides in the swamplands east of the fort. So... let us make our escape and venture there post haste.
I could tell you all about Swamp Dreamers too. Shoot, that much dreamer.
Oh, do hold your prickly tongue.
Sorry to wake you up, bud, but I'm in the middle of a quest here.
What? But I was... it was... please, tell me. Why did you wake me?
And you smell of burnt hair and barren dreams. But I have the good breeding not to mention it.
They don't call us dreamers.
Dreamers are nothing, yeah. Afraid.
My purpose is to dream. And for that, I need oranges. Is that what he told you he's missing? Well, I suppose it's technically true. Though I'd guess Mr. Griff is more upset about the Trudenay. Citrus.
Gonna go with that.
It's all here, I'm afraid. On my person. You found me. But I am I need to dream. I, above all others, it is my vocation. My Trudenay. It makes you master. Of all you see when you sleep, the dreamer is not the play actor.
But the playwright.
It may be hard for you to understand. My kind, we dream for the greater good.
What huh?
See, can predict the truth. Can even shape the truth.
Good lord, man. I think somebody might need to stage an intervention.
Before I was caught, before I was brought here, I saw a vision. The void woken, slain. But just as I was about to see how it happened, the Magisters beat down my door. This is my last chance to find out the secret, to find out how to save us all. So you see, I cannot give back the Trudenay.
What?
Not only for myself, but for all of us. My dreams are my gift.
I'm not gonna be able to do it.
Salvation to...
Okay, maybe I did. Because the last times I've had to use persuasion, it always told me I needed a minimum of two in order to do it, and they're always failures, so.
Mad. And it won't be long before he'll have it, with all his thoughts lurking about. Stick me in my sleep if they knew. Fine, fine, take the Trudine. I'll find more. Another way.
So he's back to sleeping. Man, I can steal this guy blind. He ain't gonna care. Although, to be on the safe side, hopefully we can get this quest finished up.
An elf, caked in mud and blood, looks up at you from the bottom of the cage. He holds his shoulder at a strange angle. Despite his condition, he appears eager for your attention.
Oh, God, I don't even remember. Probably a tuna fish sandwich first comes to mind. Peanut butter sandwich. Still thinking. Pineapple. Yup. And to tell the truth, my store started carrying tuna fish sandwiches recently. So because of that, my weight is starting to steadily climb back up. So I think what's gonna happen with that is I'm gonna have to. It's one of the reasons whenever I stream here in the morning. That I have to leave early, or I have to cut it off early because I have to go to the other grocery store. That's one of the things I have to buy over there is tuna salad. Yep. But yeah, loved it ever since I was a kid. I used to really chow down on pineapple too, but not so much anymore because eating too many of that and the canker sores start erupting, so.
But I am a thief.
He perks up and wipes his face with his good hand.
Oh my God. Got some kind of allergy going on here.
She knows I help you. It is all prepared. It is ready. I am too weak to go. But I must care for Sahela. I am no fool. If you can leave, you do leave. Free me first. Then I tell you everything I know. Thank you.
Oh, thanks, White.
did me.
Griff glances from his blade to you and back again.
Spare the indignation and hand it over. Now. Good boy. Looks like everything's accounted for. Now the important question.
This Griff is nothing but a thug. Don't give up Stingtails so easily.
Okay, so looks like I'm faced with a tough call right here.
I'm right chuffed to have my supplies back, so I'm gonna give you one last chance. Tell me who you found them on, or you're gonna have to answer to me, my knife, and each one of my people. With your little elf, then I'll make you out alive.
If I gotta face everybody and their frickin' dog in this battle, I'm not even gonna bother fighting it.
Oh, you must think I'm playing with you. I don't play, and I'm over.
So I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm counting 5 opponents here. No. Question is now is, who do I flee? Where do I flee to? Oh, bullshit. I gotta throw something at him. No, I don't wanna drop it. I wanna throw it. Here, let's toss an egg at him. Because otherwise, Red Prince is going to be dead for sure. Because he's sleeping right now. And I didn't know you can cast chloroform from that far away. I thought you had to be standing right next to him in order to do it. So... and I definitely don't want to attack him. Otherwise, we'll end up having to kiss the Red Prince bye-bye. Because I'm pretty sure they'll kick his ass for sure. The only thing I can think of. Okay, that got him up. Let's keep running. Never mind, he's out. Guess that was a waste of effort. Akitaro. There we go. Got out of it. Alright. So, Red Prince is dead, so I'm on my own now. But the way they make it sound like here, making it look sound like he's revivable, but I'm under the impression that he can't come back.
When another divine arises, will source change back? What if there are no source?
So I'm gonna go ahead and quick save. Actually, since I'm at a good stopping point right now, I'm gonna go ahead and put my grapes back in the fridge, and I'll probably get me something to drink while I'm up. I'll be back. I think it can be, but I'm playing this on PC. And we're back to this again. So, I don't know if there's any way to smooth things over. All right, back to the beach. So, the way it's looking right now, I might end up once again having to start the game over, but this time I'm gonna have to lose the honor mode. Lose the honor, which I actually like having, but the problem is the only time you can choose honor mode is on the most highest difficulty setting. If you could have honor mode on an easy difficulty, then it'd be much less of an issue. Why? I'm only in chapter 2. Yeah, that's the thing. I may have to shift down the difficulty. I mean, on one end, it's actually a good challenge, but the problem is they way overpower me. I would have thought that at some point, with the gear I have, with everything I've accomplished, I'd be a good matchup for the rest of the enemies, but no, that's not the case. Skull? I don't know. That could be a long ways off too. Because right now, there is no way I'm going to be able to do anything at all in Fort Joy. But I guess before I continue on, let me go on my notepad and type this down. Jeez. So, 53 hours, and I'm basically better off just going ahead and starting over then. Because I haven't even scratched the surface of this game, so it'd be no big deal if I started over. Now, if I was at like the 50 hour mark or something, then yeah, I might have to try to tough it out, but, or might have to figure something out, but I hadn't even started this game, so. But I'm gonna. And I forgot to mention, I'm gonna have some V8 energy drinks. And I'm gonna go ahead and have a Reese's peanut butter egg. They got those in now. Bad call. Cause now, teleporting to the Fort Joy waypoint puts me right in front of all of the enemies. So now, in order for me to visit the town, I basically have to hoof it all the way there. So, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. See, I already have that one turned on. See, originally, this is the one I went with right here. And they don't really mention Okay, let me go back on the browser because the game doesn't really explain what each difficulty is. Nope, it's not the one I'm looking for. So, Explorer is the easiest. So I guess For the normal level seems like it'd be classic. So it looks like the default one would be classic then. That's fine. The only add-on I'm using is extra movement speed. Because they move slow as hell otherwise. But yeah, I already looked up the difficulty levels. The normal default level is classic, so that's what I went with. Like I said, I wish you had honor mode on all the difficulty levels, but nope, you just only have it on the hardest one. Glad you like it. And I'm also thinking about trying something different too. The problem is, what? Because as much as I like the role class, as much as I like, picking pockets, stealing stuff, disarming traps and all that, it's real tedious. I mean, I like the fact that the game has sight cones, like they do in Metal Gear Solid, but it also makes doing that kind of thing really... the only word I can come up with is tedious. Plus, to say nothing of the fact that once you steal an item, if the person you stole from, and possibly anybody else around that area, if they catch you with it, you're screwed either way. I mean, you either have to give the item back, I think there was an option C, but... Or option B was being, you're pretty much gonna have to fight everybody in that section of town, which you're already screwed any, which, good luck trying to beat that. So, I guess this time around, I'll just go ahead and, I'll just play it straight. No stealing, no nothing. want to see what the Shadow Blade is. Oh, damn! Looks like his skull got cracked in two. It's like Terminator without the red eye sock, or without the red eyes. Got gems embedded in their skulls. Never seen that before. Terminated. But I'm just wanting to see what Shadow Blade has. Okay, so they're a scoundrel and polymorph. Might have forgot to put that on my Twitch description. I'm new to this game myself. But the first character I went with was Rogue. But yeah, so if you're playing on Classic, I don't know. But like I said, I'm totally new to this game myself. I mean, the Rogue class can be a fun one, if only tedious. Because as far as stealing stuff goes, it doesn't work like Baldur's Gate. Like, all the enemies have like sight cones, and if you're in that sight cone, you're busted and you're taken out of stealth. So what I had to do is I had to have one of my allies go up to that person that I'm trying to steal from, initiate a conversation to get his back turned towards me, and then get behind him and start stealing. Scoundrel, warfare, dual wielding. Oh, that chameleon cloak makes you invisible, but only for two turns. Don't know what tentacle or don't know what atrophy is. Definitely don't want to be a wizard. Clear? Warfare, Geomancer is Earth magic. I'm playing on PC, but I am using a PlayStation 4 controller for it. Definitely don't need that. If anything, probably persuasion. Okay, I've had that before. So this fighter really isn't much of a fighter. Probably more like that battle mage I saw earlier. Crippling Blow looks cool. So this is basically melee and earth magic then. Let's look up Inquisitor. Warfare and Necromancy. Add NPCs. Oh, I'll show you something here. Let me find it. If you're doing a solo run, I don't know if you already know this, but you'll most certainly want the lone wolf talent. That being, you can only have one extra buddy in your group, so. Yeah, so no more than one. When I was playing as a rogue, I basically had to have another one, have a companion with me, because like I said, I used my companion to draw my target's attention away from me so I could sneak up behind him and steal stuff. But also, like I said, with him doing that, it's also really tedious to have to go through all that trouble. Okay, so we basically have a combat-based necromancer here. Oh. So this basically makes him undead then. Let's try night then. Warfare two-handed. Don't they have a pure tank in this game? Metamorph. Two-handed and polymorph. And I ain't doing no range crap. So basically, ranger and fire magic. That's burning. So this is a bit like a Geomancer in Final Fantasy Tactics? A geomancer in there, they did spells based on what kind of surface they were standing on. Kind of like to know if these abilities had cooldowns too. Not unless if... There's a... I see a number 4 down there in the lower right corner, the tooltip. I wonder if that means... I wonder if that's the cooldown. Here, let me help. Let me look that up real quick. Okay, search. Yeah, don't say. Okay, so we're back to start. Scavenger on polymorph. Wayfarer looks like range and earth magic. Witch, scoundrel, and necromancy? That's a weird combination. Blood Omen, Legacy of Kain kind of comes to mind. What are those Legacy of Kain games? Kain can go into stealth, sneak up behind people and kill them. Plus he could also suck their blood as well. That's an interesting one right there. Fire and Earth. Yep. So, Fighter and Air. Not sure what a shock does. I'm guessing it's a 6-turn cooldown? My Jesus. Okay, cleric. So water and necromancy. Man, they got some weird setups here. Rain. Uh. Yeah. Pretty much. I'm just trying to make it work. One thing I'm noticing on here though, is the damn cooldowns are pretty long. So it looks like we got fire and necromancy here. Oh, just straight up summoning. Oh, there it is. Now it's just warfare on Earth. Warfare and necromancy. Looks like this guy here is the pure fighter. That's the one I'm looking for. He's a knight. Trying to make him a tank. Don't care for bartering. I do about persuasion, though. I'll have to grab a shield eventually. Probably go with that one. Shorter cooldown. Wish I could get rid of those. Undead, male, human. Definitely going with Jester. Some reality leads you to other time. Oh. So yeah, I'll probably go with Scholar again. So it looks like I got my guy. Oh, cool. I can still pick locks. And I guess I'll watch the cutscene again.
I'd planned. I was shackled and collared and sent to Fort Joy. I'd come here to kill Godwoken, but instead I became part of their story.
Still a bit groggy, are we?
I forgot to change his face. No.
Soon enough.
Yeah. Every time I change classes, his face reset. Well, fuck that up.
Easy now. No need to hurry. Get your... Although, seeing someone wrapped up like that, they probably thought you had the scabbing plague. Eh? Look, laugh, but don't touch. Better keep that hood down, mind you. The living don't take kindly to seeing their future staring back at them.
Okay, as picky as it might sound, I'm gonna have to go back and recreate them. Single player, classic. So let's try that again. Actually, what I could do is just look it up. Big fighter. Maybe make a fighter thief. Maybe make a ranger? Okay, let me check out this image real quick.
You remove your bulldozer from the street.
More damage. Man, so I sort of kind of created my own. I can basically create my own setup here. Wish I'd known this sooner. Care about that. Last junk. Oh, first let me get close. Yeah, that one.
Prepare yourself.
Don't want that one. Okay, so it already did that then. So again, Jester and Scholar. Just gonna skip it.
So, still a bit easy now.
I wish they would have gotten the original voice actor for this. Grinning Skull, I believe it's a reference to Mort the Talking Skull off of Planescape Torment. I wish they would have gotten that voice actor instead of whoever this one was.
Better keep that hood down, would you? The living don't take kindly to seeing their future staring back at them.
It's got a 6-turn cooldown. Yep. A 6-turn cooldown. That doesn't start until you actually end the spell. Yeah. Okay, something else I want to do, because I don't really see me advancing a whole lot in this game. Oh, forgot about that. Once you pick something, it's permanent. And, let me go on my Twitch description here. Okay, so it's already in there, modded. So I can now talk to animals. And if by some great grand miracle I actually do get the quirk, I think it's called Pet Pal, then all interactions will be positive ones.
Shaking her fluffy coat, the sheep eyes you bathe, her rectangular eyes like letterboxes to the void. With
banded like a chicken's leg, but not much meat on your bones.
The depth of unamused ennui staring back at you from those ovine eyes is startling.
Are you referring to the ballerina?
With two shakes of her stumpy tail, the sheep turns away from you to peruse her hay-filled mate.
Should be able to pick it. Oh, damn. Now I'm starting to really think about switching to a role class again. Diablo 2? Diablo, I did try playing, but, same problem I had with a lot of other those GOG games that I downloaded. They're full screen only, and I have to be able to play windowed. I think I've tried playing Diablo 3 recently. I couldn't get into it. Diablo 2, for me to take that game up again, I'd have to also grab my hero editor and use it as well. So, you know, I think when I first started uploading content, it was Diablo 2 when I was, I used a hero editor, modded a lot of my gear, and ended up getting a lot of shit for it, despite the fact that I actually typed out, hey, I'm using a hero editor, but I don't remember my reasoning, probably something like, if not for the hero editor, I wouldn't be playing this game at all, or I would have been one of the rare few that said, Diablo 2 sucks, you know, or something like that. But I still got called out for being a cheater anyway. But yeah, I guess I'm too burnt out on Diablo 3 to play it again. And again, like I said with Diablo 2, I'd have to have a hero editor on there. But doing that means I'd probably have to deal with the occasional viewer that comes up, damn, dirty cheater, or some shit. I mean, hell, I've seen some players use those hero editors, and they come up with gear that, with mods, that literally take up the whole entire screen. Like a full fucking list, just for one piece of equipment. I'm like, I ain't that bad. I think what I did is, I went on a website called the Ariat Summit. It had a list of all the mods a certain piece of equipment could have, and the stat ranges. That's what I went by. And it, now that I think about it, me using cheats is, I'd have the same opinion on cheats as I would on bodybuilders using steroids. I mean, yeah, they enhance your recovery ability. You can get stronger a lot faster. But, you know, you still gotta go work out. I mean, you still gotta go in there, you still gotta lift weights, and you still have to lift properly, too. You know, you still have to avoid injury. I mean, granted, if you do get injured, you're gonna recover from it, you know, super quick because of the roids you're on, but you still gotta lift weights. You still gotta put in the work. I mean, kind of the same thing I said with cheats. Unless you're using something like infinite health, infinite ammo, etc. I mean, yeah, those I wouldn't use, but I mean, I still gotta play the game. I mean, I still gotta avoid getting killed. I mean, you know, I still gotta, you know, pick up the loot. I still have to go through all the quests and whatnot, so it's not like it's a one-click win situation. You know, same thing here. I mean, or any other game where I use cheats. I mean, I still gotta play the game. I mean, I still gotta be careful to avoid fucking up and getting myself killed.
Did you expect a needle?
That will probably come in handy. Yeah, I forgot there's something else you can do in this game. You can move boxes. There we go. Did not know that. Oh, wow. Yeah, did not know that. Divine Divinity. Never heard of that one. Crate I'll need. The box. Knox? I never heard of that one either. Uh-oh. Oh, and you still get slowed afterwards.
Before you can even touch the lever, you hear a sniff and snort behind you as the snoring magister mumbles himself awake.
So my shift over.
Why, you're no magister.
You're a sorcerer. What are you doing here, filthy scrounger? Choose your words carefully.
My fists ache to meet a new face.
Got it.
And it's about time, too. The lads and lasses.
Oh, damn. I'm really beginning to think about switching characters back to my rogue again. I'm gonna go on my notepad and type this down. Save that for later.
Can't just leave the prisoner alone, though. I heard he might be the one causing trouble upstairs.
Yeah.
That's all I needed to hear. Just don't let that caged rascal fool you. You can't trust him as far as you can throw him.
Bye. Bad call, I guess. Got a bit of a martial arts fight going here. In World of Warcraft, that was my main. My main was a druid.
The prisoner's gaze finds the sunken hollows that once held your eyes. He speaks not with gratitude, but with gleeful malevolence.
Yeah. Oh shoot, I'm fighting him too. Be a straightforward knockdown, drag out fight here. What would he have? Nice crit when he only had a few health left. And there's also a skill, ability, trait, whatever. Standing in blood heals you.
Junk.
I'll pick that up. There's my fire barrel. Yeah. Poison heals you. Okay, maybe not. Oh, back up, back up. Oh, wait, no.
And I'm back where I started.
Nice. I still need to find a bedroll yet. Okay, okay, apparently I can sneak.
There you are. Not too tight, I hope. The collar, I mean. Oh, not to worry. Every dog has to get used to its leash. In the meantime, your next stop will be Magister William. All passengers have to be registered in the ship's manifest, and he's the chap in charge of the logs.
And before I continue on, I'm gonna break off for a moment or two. I'm gonna get me something else to eat. I'll be right back. I'm gonna close my blinds as well. I'll be back.
Find him on the other side of this deck, in the officer's quarters. Don't you dare! If you violate the virtue of my carpet, I'll do a good deal worse and put a collar around your neck.
Index fingers pressed to her lips, she pauses a moment to give you a scrutinizing glance.
My word, you do seem a bit befuddled, don't you? Perhaps I was a... Oh, well, I'm sure you'll soon gather your wits. Most likely. Eventually. A new life awaits. And if you're a particularly good boy, perhaps a cure as well. An end to Source. For good. Is he? Oh, well. Some problems simply sort themselves, don't they?
She frowns and peers at you closely. Concern clearly etched upon her face.
Delusions such as these are rare, but not unheard of. I recommend a cup of mulled wine and a night's sleep.
Gotta have me some lima beans.
Why, for my peace of mind, of course. Why don't you try casting one of those
currents of magic surge inside you, boiling, bursting, then breaking.
You better stop before you hurt yourself. All will, but no result. There you have it. See? The collar's function. It neuters you of sorts. Makes you unable for your own peace of mind. Of course.
Thank you.
Yours and the whole world's.
Yes. Yep. Yippers. Llama. Yeah, 20 poop out. Got out of that one. That's right, I can't pickpocket him.
Ugly sight, isn't it? Burns me up this happened under our protection. We're extremely lucky no Voidwalker can follow the source that did. The Finn didn't see it like that. He was desperate for us to help him. Two things scared them. We'll find out who did this. Speaking of...
She looks up at you with a mirthless smile.
I was on duty in your room when the murder happened. You would have said you're one of the only indisputably innocent people on the ship. Unless you can commit murder in your sleep, of course. Finn was killed by Source. It looks more like a passenger managed to slip their collar. Listen, I could use ring me a good lead, and I'll throw in a shiny gold coin for you. How about that? A man of principle. I get it. Wonder how you'll feel when whoever did. You let me know if you hear anything. Whoever did.
Speaking of that, I need to run in here and do this.
No indications of a struggle.
There's a broken source collar in here too somewhere. There it is. Nab that. There we go. I changed his skull to the way I want it, but then I totally forgot to change his name. God, I am such a retard. Doubt it.
Closest to our divine, like wolves are at a campfire.
Well, you've got this wolf on a leash now.
As soon as the Inquisitor gets here, we'll hang you right over the side of this ship with him.
A scruffy man lounges against the wall with scarred arms folded. A slight...
Watch your back, new fish.
As rolling his eyes at the Magister's warning, the man leans in. And
pinches less that way, right?
Hocking a phlegmy gobbet in your general direction, the Solemn Magister settles back to his task of glowering at Ifa. And now, you.
We used to know each other, more than...
Standing far back from Ifan grins, flashing...
Okay, just gonna speed through these.
Same as he was at 14 years old. Only difference is somebody gave him a bigger sword. Long story. Maybe I'll tell you about it in the joy. Away from... no. The dead man. Finn, is it? I'd no business with him.
He glances over at Magister Victor, who's staring back at him with...
damn shame. Sheer annoyance isn't reason enough. The joy. I've heard a lot. Wonder if we'll get to meet the Ringmaster himself. Not eager to bow before the great Bishop Alexander, son of the divine...
What are you conspiring about?
Oh, don't mind him.
Name!
Magister Victor looks at you suspiciously, then scrawls something illegible down in a tiny notebook. He scarfs...
Away with you. At once.
Ifan performs an elaborate pantomime of keeping quiet.
Never thought you'd end up a prison guard, Vic.
That's right. I always knew you'd turn up rotten, Ben Nest. Your kind always hung closest to our divine, like wolves around a campfire.
Well, you've got this wolf on a leash now.
As soon as the Inquisitor gets here, we'll hang you right over the side of this ship with him.
You're one of them. I know it.
But you put a knuckle on it. I'm trying to do something.
They don't care about us. We're the cattle to them.
I spent my life singing for my slaves. Meanwhile,
one of us took our own. They're picking us off.
Well,
right,
well. The lizard looks you all of a sudden. He grips you firmly by the chin, with the intent of inspecting you.
Now then, to business. You will answer me three questions. The first one is this. And of course, a cook who can't taste is about as useful as
a dog in a chess game.
On to the second question. Can you knit, weave? In short, tailor? I can tell from your... On then to my final query. Have you the ability to administer the upkeep of one's personal appearance? The delicate art of... Just as I thought. So, three questions are... As per your own testimony, you have the taste, but that won't do at all, see? I'm sad to say I must deny you the opportunity to be my slave. Ever so sorry. I know. Still.
One of them. I know it.
Would you put a knuckle in it? I'm trying to concentrate.
They don't care about us. We're like cattle to them.
I'll give you that knuckle if you keep carrying on.
One of us will kill our own. They're picking us off one by one.
I want to try some.
Can we just skip?
The facts are unknown.
I reassure you and you shut up.
That's what...
Mad?
Some of these items... Some of them say effects unknown, but if you drink it or consume it, it'll tell you what it does.
You are. And would you please tell this very charming... How very correct...
What? Her pinched face.
Yeah, okay.
Like I said, just, just zipping through these.
You presume right. Nope. trying not to find anything out either. Ignorance is bliss. The utterer, the better.
Suddenly, her eyes clapped as quickly as they can.
Good luck, Chief.
Okay, and I gotta look for a stern room key. Excuse me. It'll probably take a little while to explain, but let me pull it up real fast. There's one big, huge stumbling block that's keeping me from getting there. But like I said, I gotta pull it up. Come on. Okay, so let's go here. Let's go here. But this is what's killing me right here. I have to have an average of 3 viewers. And I think I have to maintain that for at least 30 days. But, I'd kind of like getting it too, but it's not going to happen. It's mainly due to the way this metric works, because they're averaging this out, you know, how many hours I stream, and I stream every day. So, and they're just dividing that out, which comes out to, I think probably the highest I ever had this was 1.6. Yeah, cause you live in Scotland, Skull. Guitaro lives in France, and I'm here in the United States. So it's really hard to get the times aligned just right. Oh, excuse me. So let me do another search.
Got this wolf on a leash now.
Oh, thank you, Guitaro. But, I suppose something else I could probably do that I haven't done in a very long time is, I'll do, like, a commentary video on, usually somebody on, like, the Twitch Reddit, they'll wonder what they can do to improve their stream. I'll usually do commentary videos on that kind of stuff. But yeah, I'm kind of long overdue for that. But yeah, like I said, I pass everything else with flying colors. It's just that one metric that's keeping me from getting there. Guitaro, that's a major issue right there. Because I don't do PS4 anymore. I can't hardly do anything at all when it comes to streaming. That's why I switched over to PC. So I can do so much more on a PC than I can on a PS4.
The collar of his uniform and chuckles.
Sorry you're upset, sir, but we all wear what we wear for a reason. You head on in now. Williams will get you sorted fast.
Yeah. There was something else I was supposed to read in here. Alright, let me try inventory. There we are. Shadow pinball. Go for it.
Top door's barricaded. No way to for now.
Standing at the center of the room, you
spot here we go.
Reportedly eyeing a pair of nervous looking magisters.
So you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella.
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
Nope. Not anymore. They kind of dropped the ball on that, Skull. They don't make any more new tables. Now they just let other companies make them.
There are others whose lives must end.
Good God, the woman's mad. You there, sorcerer, go and fix Magister Siwan. We need to do more to collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
By all means, do as the officer says, but you had better hurry, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, man, quickly! If she casts source, the void worker will come. They'll end us...
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
Boom! Yeah, it. I like my graphics to look original, but Pinball FX3s have this slick, modern, greasy look to them. Plus, the physics on FX3 is totally different than on Pinball Arcade. It doesn't always work for some of the new tables that FX3 brings in. Whoops. Again. Or sprint. Okay, maybe not. Close enough. Still locked. Let me burning block by magic armor. Looks like the armor restores itself. Yep. Okay, you know what? Since I'm at a good stopping point right now, okay, all right, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and shut her down. I have to work tonight, so, all right, I gotta leave for work here in a couple hours. So, I still got plenty to do. Gotta get going on my blog post. Gotta type some more stuff down on that. Plus, I want to get a nap in there as well. So, but aside from that, thanks for dropping in, guys. And tomorrow, it's gonna be Final Fantasy 14. But like usual, I don't know how long it's gonna be. Could be a full session, could be a partial session, I don't know. We'll see come tomorrow. But yep. But until then, guys, thanks again for coming, and I'll see you all tomorrow.